Hey, and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to install Linux on a Windows 11 machine. Now I know what you're thinking, why would you want to run Linux on a Windows machine? Well, there are actually plenty of great reasons to consider it. There's two Linux only tools and learning and experimentation. So let's jump in and get started installing Linux on Windows 11. First things first, to run Linux we need to enable Windows Subsystem for Linux, or WSL. It sounds technical, but it's actually pretty easy. Here's how. Let's start by clicking the start menu and typing Windows Features. You should see an option to turn on Windows Features on or off. Click that. Scroll down until you see Windows Subsystem for Linux and Virtual Machine Platform. Click them both and then restart your machine. Once your computer restarts, load up Command Prompt and type the following commands. We are going to install all the necessary components. This will take a couple of minutes. There are several options, but a great place to start, and one of the most popular, is Ubuntu. It's widely used by both pros and beginners. If you don't want to watch the installation process, feel free to skip ahead. Now let's pick a username and password. I'm going to use the username subscribe for the username, so please don't forget to subscribe to this channel, it really helps out. One of the first things you should do is make sure everything is up to date. Type the following commands to upgrade and update. This will take a couple of minutes. Feel free to skip ahead if you don't want to watch this part. Let's try installing the app VLC Media Player using this command. If you get the following error, use this command to update. Try again. This install will take around a minute to complete. Now let's try and install the VLC Player app again. Now it's installed, let's load up VLC Player and make sure everything works. You can tell it's installed by Linux with the Linux logo. Now let's take a look at a few troubleshooting commands. These are handy for checking system information or resolving issues. Type in the following command. Now you can see all the system information from the device. Now let's go to the Microsoft Store to see what else we can install. Now let's click get and install it. Skip ahead if you don't want to see the installation process, as this will take a couple of minutes. Now it's installed, let's create a username and password. Now let's install John the Ripper password cracker using the following command. If you get the following error message, you'll need to run this command to update. Now that everything is updated and installed, let's try that again. Now let's exit and see where everything is installed.
And there you have it. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It really, really helps me grow the channel.